In this video, we're going to look at the definition of simple interest, and we're going to learn the formula and how to work with it. So first, we need a little bit of terminology. Okay, so read with me. When you deposit money into a savings account or investment, your money will earn interest. When you borrow money from a financial institution, you will be charged interest. The time for which the money is invested and borrowed is the term of the investment or loan. The simple interest is paid at maturity, which is the end of the term for an investment. The amount of interest earned depends on three things. Okay? The first thing is the amount of money borrowed and invested, and that is called the principal, or P, we use. Also depends on the annual interest rate, and we use a little r, and of course the time t for which the money is invested. Since the interest rate is an annual interest rate, annual means yearly. The time, of course, is also measured in years. When time is given in months or days, it must be converted to a fraction of a year. Okay, so a little bit of prior knowledge that we need to work with in order to help us calculate interest, or in this case, simple interest. Okay, first things first, interest rates are given as percentages, but we always need to change them into decimal form. So for example, you might remember this from previous math classes, 9% can be written as 0.09. And if you're forgetting how to do that, remember you're just dividing by 100 or moving the decimal two places to the left. Okay, a little more complicated one is 2.75%. What I always recommend for people is just to imagine it as about just being 2% for a minute. So it's 0.02, and then the 75 is just tacked on. Okay, so go ahead, pause the video, and convert those six all by yourself to decimals. Okay, take a look, pause the video, check your work, see how you did. Okay, so the second thing that we need to be comfortable with is changing the time to be in years, because time is measured in years, okay? So just a little reminder that there are 12 months in a year, there are 52 weeks in a year, and there are 365 days in a year. So in order to convert 9 months into a year, we have to take 9. It's 9 out of 12 months in a year, and we need to convert that into a decimal. Okay, you can leave it right as a fraction in your question, but I think most of you will enjoy putting it as a decimal. Okay, so for instance, 54 days, it's 54 out of 365 days in a year. Go ahead, punch that into your calculator. I get a number like 0.1479452. Now, we are going to need to round that, so probably something about 1479 is good. The more decimals you keep, the more accurate your calculations will be, so you do really want to keep it as accurate as possible. 0.148 would also be acceptable there, but please don't round it to one decimal place. Okay, same thing. I want you to try these next 8 questions. Pause the video, see if you can get them right. Okay, so pause the video, check out how you did there. Okay, so time to look at the formula for simple interest. So it's I equals PRT. I standing for interest. P standing for principal. R standing for the interest rate, as we discussed before. One thing you need to know is this is as a decimal. So you write it as a decimal, and note the time is defined in years, okay? So that's why we were reviewing that, to make sure that you understood that. And of course, just to make sure that you're clear, this I stands for interest, of course. Okay, so let's take a look at a quick example. $300 is invested for 2.5 years at 6% simple interest. How much interest is earned? Okay, so I'm looking for 3 lines here. First one is the formula, I equals PRT. By the way, since you don't see anything here, that does mean multiply. Sometimes people often like to put them in brackets instead, to emphasize that, instead of putting X's in there. Okay, I call it the PERT formula, if you like. Then we're going to substitute our values in. Okay, principal is the amount invested or borrowed. So in this case, it's the $300. The rate is 6%. We're going to write that, remember, as a decimal, so 0.06. And the time is already given in years. It's 2.5 years. Okay, now you simply pick up your calculator and you punch in those numbers, remember, with a multiplication in between. Note, when you are multiplying, it doesn't matter what order you actually multiply them. So I usually start at the left in this case, but it wouldn't matter if you start at the right as well. Okay, so go ahead and punch that into your calculator. Now this one should work out nicely to $45, okay? So what does that mean? The interest earned is $45. And of course, we're looking for dollar signs there in terms of our understanding. Let's try another one. Credit card company charges an interest rate of 6.75% per year on unpaid balances. Sue has an outstanding balance of $1,124 on her card for 35 days. How much interest did she pay? Okay, same thing. Let's go ahead. Our first step is going to be to write out the formula. I equals P times R times T. Okay, and let's see, pause the video, see if you can figure out what goes in all of those places. Okay, principal is $1,124. Interest rate is 6.75%. Remember, think of it as 6%, 0.0675 just gets tacked onto the end. Now, here's where the time is 35 days. So that means we have to take 35 and we have to divide it by 365 days in a year. So you can go ahead and get the decimal over at the side of your page if you want. Or the other thing that you could do is just put it all right here and then punch it into your calculator. So because it's all multiplication and division, it actually doesn't matter what order you even do it in. So personally, if I was gonna pick up my calculator here and punch it all in one, I would start right over here. I would punch in 35 divided by 365. I would hit equals, and then I would just multiply by 0.0675, multiply by 1,124. And when I do that, I get a whopping $7.28. So note, I got 2752. And so we're going to get used to rounding here because we are talking about money. So we do want two decimal places. And so the interest is $7.28. Okay, let's try one more. Okay, so just taking a look at this question over here, we're going to determine the interest for $300 for 18 months at 8% per year. So this is a good chance for you to pause the video and try to do that one all on your own. So write down your formula, substitute the values in, and go ahead and calculate it. Okay, so check it out, see how you did. You should have gotten $36 in interest. So now the one other thing I'm going to add is, what does that mean at the end of the 18 months or the 1.5 years? What does that mean the amount of your investment is, right? How much money do you have at the end if we're talking about an investment, or even if we're talking about owing somebody money? Okay, and it's very simple. We are simply going to take the principal, and we're going to add the interest, and that should make logical sense to you. So in this case, our principal was $300, and then we're going to add the $36 in interest. And so now the total amount of money is $336. So that's how much money you would have at the end of 18 months. Okay, you're going to practice this a little bit. Good luck.